स्वराज्य हा माझा जन्मसिद्ध हक्क आहे आणि तो मी मिळवणारच. स्वराज्य इज माय बर्थ राईट अँड आय विल अक्वायर इट नो मॅटर द कॉन्सिक्वेन्सेस. दिस वॉज द इंटरप्रिट स्टेटमेंट मेड बाय केशव गंगाधर टिळक, ऑल्सो नोन एज बाळ गंगाधर टिळक. केशव गंगाधर टिळक वॉज बॉर्न ऑन 23 July 1856 इन अ मराठी हिंदू चित्पावन ब्राह्मण फॅमिली इन रत्नागिरी.
द यंग टिळक was educated at Deccan College in Pune, where in 1876 he earned bachelor's degrees in mathematics and Sanskrit. Tilak then studied law, receiving his degree in 1879 from the University of Bombay. At that point, however, he decided to teach mathematics in a private school in Pune. Inspired by Vishnu Shastri Chipudankar, he co-founded the New English School for Secondary Education in 1880 with a few of his college friends. The success of the school led them to set up the Deccan Education Society in 1884 to create a new system of education that taught young Indians nationalist ideas through an emphasis on Indian culture. The society established the Ferguson College in 1885 for post-secondary studies, where Tilak himself taught mathematics. The life members of the society were expected to follow an ideal of selfless service. But when Tilak learned that some members were keeping outside earnings for themselves, he immediately resigned from the position.
He then turned to the task of awakening the political consciousness of the people through two weekly newspapers that he owned and edited. First one was Kesari, published in Marathi, and the Maratha, published in English. Through those newspapers, Tilak became widely known for his bitter criticisms of British rule. To widen the popularity of the nationalist movement by introducing Hindu religious symbolism, Tilak organized two important festivals, the Ganesh festival in 1893 and the Shiva Jayanti celebration in 1895, because he believed that knowledge and nationalism were of utmost importance in establishing Swarajya. Tilak's activities aroused the Indian populace, but they soon also brought him into conflict with the British government, which prosecuted him for sedition and sent him to jail in 1897. The trial and the sentence of 18 months earned him the title Lokmanya, which means beloved leader of the people.
When Lord Curzon, the Viceroy of India, partitioned Bengal in 1905, which was a strategy set out by Lord Curzon to weaken the nationalist movement, Tilak encouraged the Swadeshi movement and the boycott movement. The following year, he set forth a program of passive resistance known as the Tenets of the New Party that he hoped would destroy the hypnotic influence of the British rule and prepare the people for sacrifice to gain independence. These forms of political action initiated by Tilak, the boycotting of goods and passive resistance, were later adopted by Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi in his program of non-violent non-cooperation with the British. This was known as Satyagraha.
Tilak aimed at Swarajya, that is independence, and he attempted to persuade the Congress party to adopt his militant program. On that issue, he clashed with the moderates during the party session at Surat in 1907, and the party split. Taking advantage of the division in the nationalist forces, the government again prosecuted Tilak on a charge of sedition and inciting terrorism and deported him to Mandale, Burma, to serve a 6-year prison sentence. Any other man would have given up, but not Lokmanya Tilak. Even in jail, he was persistent and determined during pursuing his nationalist philosophy. In the Mandale jail, Tilak settled down to write his magnum opus, the Srimad Bhagavad Gita Rahasya, which is an original exposition of the most sacred book of the Hindus. Tilak discarded the orthodox interpretation that the Bhagavad Gita taught the ideal of renunciation. In his view, Bhagavad Gita taught selfless service to humanity.
However, Tilak was also a learned astronomer, and he had published his erudite speculation in 1903, namely, The Arctic Home in Vedas, which is actually a book on the origin of Aryanic people. Lokmanya Tilak opposed British Orientalism not only through his political career, but also in the field of astronomy, where certain British Orientalists attempted to undermine the ancient wisdom of the Vedic texts as being borrowed from the Babylonians in the ancient past. Earlier in 1893, he had published the Orion, or Researches into the Antiquity of the Vedas. In this text, he has attempted to calculate the time of the Vedas by using the position of the vernal equinox being in Orion near the Mrugashirsha Nakshatra. From this speculation, he pushed the origin of the Vedas to 5000 BC simply by using astronomical references. It was at this time that first attempts to reform the calendar and the sacrificial system appear to have been systematically made.
On his release in 1914 from Mandalay, on the eve of World War I, Tilak once more plunged into politics. In 1916, he rejoined the Congress Party and signed the historic Lucknow Pact, a Hindu-Muslim accord with Muhammad Ali Jinnah, the future founder of Pakistan. Tilak visited England in 1918 as president of the Indian Home Rule League. He realized that the Labour Party was a growing force in British politics, and he established firm relationships with its leaders. And his foresight was justified. It was a Labour government that granted independence to India in 1947.
Tilak tried to convince Gandhi to leave the idea of total non-violence and try to get self-rule or Swarajya by all means. Though Gandhi did not entirely concur with Tilak on the means to achieve self-rule, and he was steadfast in his advocacy of Satyagraha, he definitely appreciated Tilak's service to the country and his courage of conviction. Tilak and Swami Vivekananda had great mutual respect and esteem for each other. They met accidentally while travelling by a train in 1892, and Tilak had Vivekananda as a guest in his house. A person who was present there heard that it was agreed between Vivekananda and Tilak that Tilak would work towards nationalism in the political arena, while Vivekananda would work for nationalism in the religious arena. When Vivekananda died at a young age, Tilak expressed great sorrow and paid tributes to him in the Kesari. Tilak said about Vivekananda, "At the fag of the 19th century, the second Shankaracharya is Vivekananda, who showed to the world the glory of Hinduism. His work is yet to be completed. We have lost all our glory, our independence. We have lost everything."
Even after a lifetime of struggle for the nation's freedom, Lokmanya Tilak unfortunately passed away on 1st of August 1920. On 28th July 1956, a portrait of Bal Gangadhar Tilak is put in the Central Hall of Parliament House. The portrait of Tilak, painted by Gopal Deuskar, was unveiled by the then Prime Minister of India, Jawaharlal Nehru. In 2007, the Government of India released a coin to commemorate the 150th birth anniversary of Tilak. The formal approval of the Government of Burma was received for the construction of Class-cum Lecture Hall in the Mandalay prison as a memorial to Lokmanya Tilak. 35,000 rupees were given by the Indian government and 7,500 rupees by the local Indian community in Burma.
In tributes, Gandhi called him the maker of modern India, and Jawaharlal Nehru, independent India's first Prime Minister, described him as the father of the Indian Revolution. This was a son of India, worthy of the title of Lokmanya, a man who was not only a true patriot of the Indian nation, but also an advocate of India's cultural heritage. Remembering his determination, let us emulate the ideals of nationalism and patriotism in our lives and serve our nation in every possible way. Shubhaste Panthanaha Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.